Welcome to an example on how to find a z-score on the newer version of the t84 for a standard normal distribution, given we know the probability of the z-score is less than a constant c equals 0.7853. Since the probability is the same as the area under the standard normal distribution, and in this case we have the z-score being less than c, so the area is going to be accumulated from the left, based upon what we know about the standard normal distribution, we should be able to recognize that because 78.53% is between 50 and 84%, the value of c that we're looking for is going to be between 0 and 1 standard deviations above the mean, let's just say somewhere in here. So this value of c is a z-score that we're looking for, where the probability of z being less than c equals 0.7853. Which means the area to the left of C under the standard normal distribution curve is equal to 0.7853, which should be the shaded region here. So we can find this value of C using the T84 graphing calculator in the inverse norm function found under the distribution menu. Once we enter the inverse norm function, we'll enter the probability or area to the left of the value of C. Then we enter the mean or mu, followed by the standard deviation, or sigma. And this function returns the x value with the given probability, the probability of x being less than c. However, if we let mu equal 0 and sigma equal 1, x will be the z-score with the given probability, the probability of z being less than c, which again is the case that we have here. So using the graphing calculator, we press second vars for the distribution menu. We want to select option 3, inverse norm. This is a screen that's new for the newer version of the 84. You won't find this on the older 84 or the 83. So first we're asked to enter the area, which again is the area to the left of the z-score that we're looking for. Again, we know it's going to be a z-score, not an x value, because we're going to use mu equals 0 and sigma equals 1. So the area is the same as the given probability of 0.7853. Enter. Again, because we're looking for a z-score, we're letting mu equal 0 and sigma equal 1. So we press enter down to paste. Once we're on paste, we press enter again, which copies the information that we just entered onto the home screen. Notice how if we arrow left, we see the inverse norm function, and then we have the probability or area to the left, followed by mu and sigma. So if we press enter, this gives us the z-score, or the value of c that we're looking for. So c is approximately 0.7902. Which means the probability of the z-score being less than 0.7902, because we did round this value of c, this would be approximately the given probability of 0.7853. Next, we'll look at an example where z is greater than c. I hope you found this helpful.